Okay, one more video, I think, about the 303 ejection thing and the rim thing. They're going through all the, like, the thickness of the rims seem to show, like, the thicker ones worked better, the thinner ones didn't work any better, but I think it's just sort of coincided with another issue that I kind of overlooked. 314-299 mentioned it in the comments, like, yesterday. And I was talking to him later, that the undercut and not undercut rims, like you have like the rims that have, see it or not, but they're cut, like there's a groove cut just ahead of the rim on some of like most of the commercial ones. Like none of the military ones are like that. And pretty much all the military stuff are the ones that worked better. And it appears that the ones that worked the worst functioning or ejecting through like the friction on the sidewall are the ones with the deepest groove cut into them or ditch there or trench. I did a little bit of measurements, but like I can't measure the grooves on, like I can almost sort of measure it on the federal one because it's got the seems to have the biggest one. But all I could measure was the diameter of the, like I measured the diameter of the head of the case. I don't know if that would make any difference, but the distance from the one side of the rim to the far side of the head, because the extractor it doesn't, the place that it actually contacts the, get this on in the frame here, the place that the extractor actually presses on the case itself, it's just the very tip of it here, and if there's a groove there, then it actually fits in the groove. So if that groove wasn't there, it'd actually be pushing on, more metal than it would. So that seems to be the case. So I measured it. The numbers, they don't seem to be drastically different. Like if you just measure like the head diameters without the groove. And then the distance from that to the far rim, they're all sort of close, but then if you add up the ditch in or the groove, like I don't know how deep it really is. Like some of them it has, like the Federal one is pretty deep. The Remington one is, it's hardly even there. The Winchester is, it's not much of one. Imperial is, a little bit of one. The small, sort of small font Herders, it's got a, not super deep, but it, I guess the Federal is similar to it, but it's, I don't know, like, even some of the ones that don't have much of a groove, they still worked fairly poorly, but then if you look at the distance from, the edge of the rim to the head, and you subtract a little bit, then it still doesn't, like, unless it's, I don't know, like it's hard to, like it's beyond my capabilities of measuring this stuff to find if the see if there's any real correlation there or whatever, or is it the rim thickness and that. Like the groove doing something else? Is the nose of the extractor getting sort of stuck in it or something, or is it causing some other issue that I don't, I'm really understanding here or something? Or are they all sort of working together to make it so they don't work that well? Like some of them, like most of the head diameters without the groove. Like the Imperial was like 448, But then, the defense industry was like 450, so it's but that's it doesn't have a groove. Remington Peters is 450 without the groove, but it does have a tiny little one. But so there's not a there's no real big difference in the Headhunters other than the groove. Like the only one that was really big was the small font Herders had a like a 454 head diameter, but it does have a groove. And the PPU is 453 head diameter, and it doesn't have a groove. But as far as the distances from the edge of the rim to the head, like the Dominion from 44, it's like a 495 for that measurement. And it works pretty much like really reliably, so that sort of would give you an idea that, well, that's a good distance, or it has to be that. But then you go to, say, like the Dominion from 1912, the distance from the rim to the head on the other side is only 490, so it's almost seems like it would actually theoretically be smaller or less distance between it and some of the undercut ones, but I don't have really any way to measure that, so I don't know. I'm wondering if it's not really the distance between them, or is it just the undercut is interfering with the extractor somehow, that it gets the shell gets sort of like I don't know, like gets stuck to the extractor somehow, so when it's trying to rub on the side and then throw it out, it's interfering with its movement, or like I have no idea. Like it, so it's either the combo of the rim, the undercut, and and maybe a little bit of the distance between the undercut and the outer rim, and how much pressure is being exerted, or the like, who knows? So I'm kind of I'm not gonna, I can't. I don't think I can really come to a positive conclusion on why. I'm just, it's just it seems like the commercial ones with the, like the Federal with the fairly deep undercut, and the thinner rim and all that, they just seem don't work that well, and all the military ones, like all these, pretty much all these ones worked decently, and they all don't have any kind of undercut. They're just they go straight down and then into the rim. So I don't anyway. So anyway, but I guess we found out which cases don't work very well, but as far as why, I'm not really sure yet, or really can say anything definite here. So but the undercut might have something to do with it, but it might be the thin rim interfering with more slop than it. I don't know. I have no idea. So anyway, so I guess that's probably the last video I'll do on this, because it just seems like the more and more you look into it, it just becomes more and more confusing and stuff. And it's like why it's and I don't really have the way to measure this, measure that. Test this, whatever. I could just go on forever and still not get anywhere. So it's anyway. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you find it sort of interesting. I guess it's still a good string of videos. Shows you sort of I'm going through some sort of process. I thought I found a somewhat of an easy or tried to take an easy answer, I guess, but it seems like it might not be totally the whole reason behind it. Just the rim thickness. It might just correlated, coincided with other things, and so then it sort of appears that it was the main issue or something like that. So anyway, we will talk to you later.